little high. Still, not bad. I would have probably hit the 30 target, aiming at this front one. No.
Pretty easy though.
Aim's pretty right on.
Oh yeah. There it is.
There it is. You hit it.
Hold a little bit.
First one high, but it probably would have been a kill shot still.
Oh, yeah, still been a kill shot.
And this would have been dropped. So we are out here at the archery range, and we're going to be learning all about shooting a bow and what it takes, ins or out. If you're interested in learning how to bow hunt, check with your local state and local laws about hunting and what kind of tag you need to get. Here in Montana, if you go bow hunting, you cannot do rifle hunting for the same season. So it's important to find out your local laws. Contact your local fishing game or whatever they call them in your state to know the laws before you go out and get a license. Probably any course that you have to take, they'll instruct you with that too. You can find it all online. Just to be fair to all the states out there, I'm not going to list any links. We are not professionals. We are professional hunters, but we are not part of a company or sponsored by anybody. Just a couple of hunters that want to share some educational information for you. So if you're interested in learning how to bow hunt, pay attention. Here we go.
Make sure you have a nice release that you're comfortable with. You can either have a thumb release. This is my finger release.
How much do those cost, General?
This one here costs $35.
$35. And why do you use that?
Because it's kind of hard to pull it back.
Well, I see all the Indians always pulling back on TV. It's not like TV. You don't just pull back.
Man, they didn't shoot 65 pounds. They shot like 30. 40 pounds.
40 pounds. Okay, so this is 65 pounds. Yeah. And how does this work? What's the mathematical engineering of this?
This is a dual cam system. So it has a 75% let off. So when I let go, it adds the force and it just sends them out 300 FPS.
How hard is it to hold back?
Once you get past a certain location, it's just like holding a knife.
Just holding a knife, really?
It's super light.
Okay. So no fear of fatigue for holding it, waiting for that shot.
Most of the day, just
holding it, really?
My arms don't get tired from holding my arms up.
Right. So no fear of being strong enough to hold the shot back, the arrow back.
The only thing you have to worry about is don't go too high in poundage right away. I started out with 40 pounds because I'm brand new with bow.
This is your first year actual hunting with a bow. You've always hunted with rifle. This is a brand new one too. All right, so we have the fletching back here, and what do you call the actual arrow? Is there a name for it in the tip and what?
Just an arrow. The orange piece right here is the nock. You always put the nock in the nock housing.
The nock in the nock housing, which is right there. Okay.
Well, I have hunting at the broadhead.
For hunting, you only use a broadhead. Mm-hmm. What's the difference?
Well, a broadhead versus a belt point.
Let's look at the other one. So the ones in here are what you would use if you were actually going to go hunting.
And this is a broadhead.
Oh, so the other day when we were hunting, this is what we were using. Right, there you go.
That's an inch and a quarter diameter cutting. This is a belt point. It's just basically you can shoot anything.
And the rules of this range here is for practice only, and you use this, and that's to preserve the tearing up of the target, correct?
And the actual backgrounds, yeah.
Yep. It would be awful difficult to pull out of these boards here. What are they made out of, do you know?
That is, I think it's rubber.
Rubber? The targets, let's take a look real quick. Now, I have done some bow hunting in the past, but for educational purposes, I'm going to be asking a lot of questions. Some I know the answers to, some I don't. So this is made out of carpet. What they've done is lied several different layers of carpet together, going long ways, to create a good background for arrows. That's very common. Rubber or carpet. So you have a rubber piece on each side pushing in, and a bunch of different carpets just squished together real tight.
Really tight. This is
really tight.
About 100 pounds worth of pressure.
100 pounds worth of pressure squeezing in. Big old sandwich. And there's the 65 range target all the way down at the end. And these are all yards. This isn't meters.
We're American. We need yards here.
Yards and American. That's it. For everybody at the, all the fans of the Hunter Call of the Wild.
It's all meters.
It's meters. Yeah. So what would be the equivalent? I don't know. So I know somebody's going to ask me.
25
meters?
Yep. And then 40 is about 45, 50 is about 56, 57.
So. I have a thing that goes meters or yards.
We have a thing that goes meters or yards. Let's answer that. Okay, so for the question of meters to yards, all right, we're going to use our range finder, and we're going to tell you the meters. So the furthest target, which is 65 yards, is how many meters? And that would be the last target in the center all the way down range. It won't tell you. It refuses to go European on us. Fail. We have to go to Europe in order to make it think European, so we have to think everything American here. Sorry. For the rest of the world, we apologize. This is for American hunting only, so all measurements are in American standard. Sorry. We're yardage here. Okay, so... Go ahead.
Okay. So there's a few ways to pull back, and a lot of them are wrong. I've seen people on YouTube say, well, if it's too heavy for you, you just go up all the way up and pull down. Don't ever do that, because you might go and go out somewhere out there. Always go the lightest pound as you can. If it feels comfortable, it won't hurt your shoulder up too bad. And the proper way to actually pull back on a bow is to come up about shoulder level, so your arm can go from the shoulder, and always keep your finger behind the trigger. You want your shoulder to be like you get a natural arc. So basically you go all natural down and you bring the bow down
right to your cheek. Yep. By your cheek.
And you always have
the trigger mechanism? What is actually releasing it when you pull and you decide to pull?
A little
trigger, you pull trigger. And then just lets go.
Mm-hmm.
Very effortless. Just light and it's gone.
In fact, they prefer you to actually have your finger on it when you're ready to shoot and just pull back, because that way there's no...
Yeah, just pull back on it. Don't pull with your finger. Pull with your entire hand.
And follow through. So
follow through.
You go through, you're going to keep your arm up, and then let the bow drop. The bow won't drop because you have a sling on me. It's a little sling right here. The bow will never drop on me, so.
All right.
Wind.
Clips it in. It's locked in. Finger behind the trigger, so he doesn't accidentally let it go while he's drawing back. He draws back, now it's locked in.
I always have at least two or three anchor points. I have mine on back of my neck, and I have my cheek. And then on the string, my nose. So I always have three anchor points at all times.
Just like that. And there it is, right there at 20 yards.
Hear a thump really fast and it's at 20 yards. Once you go like 65 yards, 80 yards, you're looking at 4 seconds delay.
Four second delay from where we are to the 65 yard target. It's 4 seconds for the deer or elk or bear, whatever you're hunting, to think about, there's something flying at me. And think about that. There's something flying at me and I think that I should move. Just by doing that, that's 4 seconds right there. If I could say that sentence, what do you think that animal can do when it's looking at that arrow? Bow hunting is not easy. There's a lot of disadvantages to it, and that is why bow hunting is longer season than rifle season. So now,
65 yard
shot.
With me, I don't have to worry about having the look at like five pins. I only have a single pin. I suggest my
yardage.
Your yardage is adjusted up here. You put it to 65.
Yep, 65.
And then you still use the green dot through the center.
You always want to keep that thing level as possible when you're aiming.
Level, you have a level right inside that you can see the little bubble.
If you're off a little bit,
you're going to be off.
Yeah, you can be off left and right.
So center that and then get that green dot on your target. And we're going for 65. You see that you could see the arch in that. That's crazy. You could see the arch.
Yeah.
Wow. That was a little it gives you enough time to think. And I've seen it where deer jump. They see it coming and they jump and it goes under or over them.
So the wind is coming towards us.
The wind right now is blowing this way. And it's moving the arrow and you have to adjust for that.
Yep.
Too much of an adjustment. So shot number three in the wind, and there's a good wind blowing right now.
Oh, a good 5 mile up wind.
Yeah.
Isn't much, but it does enough to the arrow.
All right, let's go check it out.
So the last one's more in the center, or closer to the center. Up and down is good, just went up and right.
Now, we are the only ones out here at the range, but always use safety, check the range, make sure nobody is on the line and that they're going to fire. Make sure everybody knows that you're coming down range. Don't think, get a verbal from everybody that you're going down range. Don't think they know. Make sure they know for safety. And before you take your shot, make sure you know nobody went down without saying something. So, here we go. Oh, steep of a hill.
This is my first shot right here because of the wind.
First shot with the wind. Second shot with adjustment over. Third shot, right there.
A little low,
but still not bad.
Anything in this white killing for a deer.
Let's look back at the ladies, and you can see where we were. You can see where the bow is hanging. You know, it's a, that is, that's a good shot. So, somebody left an arrow.
Somebody
hit way off. Please do not take. Oh, we'll be back for it. Thanks.
All right.
So somebody left a note and they nailed it in there really good.
Yeah.
And there's actual range course that you have to take that is up here. So they have archery range course. If you ever wanted to get a license and you're in the Butte, Montana area, it's probably where you would go. You can take it anywhere in the state. You don't have to take it in Butte. This is the 80 right here. Am I about 10 from you?
Yeah. 90.
So this is 80, that is 90 at the end of the lot.
I don't have 90 sight, so I'm just like guesstimate.
What does the sight go to?
80.
It goes to 80.
So I want to say it's right about.
A little more. Dead. Right there on that line.
Yeah, probably.
So this is a total guess.
I break an arrow, whatever. What's $11 down the drain, right?
for 90. This is shooting the last target all the way in the back from here, which is measured, the rangefinder.
Ooh, hit wood.
Yep.
That was a little low too.
Very low. Took forever though.
No, you're in the rubber.
I'm in the rubber.
You are. You just missed the wood.
Oh.
Wow.
Woo! That was. I also overcome that. I was aiming for here. Well, here. I was aiming for, and then the wind. It wasn't here.
Down and. To the right, all the way to the right.
All the way to the right.
Wow.
And that was 90 yards.
That was back at the end of the parking lot, at the end of the gravel, back there in front of the trucks.
Okay, on my bow, I have a little 3-inch stabilizer, so whenever I shoot my bow off, it won't vibration. No vibrations on my shots. I have an HHA Optimal light. Sight, it goes from 20 to 80. I have set to where at the very, very bottom is 20 yards. So I have all this to play with, plus more if I need to, but I would never take anything past 65, maybe even 60 yards. Let's see, you have a two-piece Easton.
So you have two-piece quiver. All right.
Standard peep sight. I mean, drop away. This is my drop away rest. That's pretty much it. I mean, I just changed my fletchings. My ends out to 65 pounds. It's all maxed out.
And you have to wax lines. What's the importance of that?
So when you're waxing your lines, they don't fray, they don't get damaged.
From being snapped?
From being snapped many times, getting dried out. You don't want that either. So these are kind of...
Do you have to remove old wax before you do that, or you just put wax on?
Put wax on, and then when you rub it in there, using that friction to heat it up.
It's like a chopstick. Just roll it out. And then apply on the line.
Just everywhere you see the line, you don't have to do the places where it has the guards on it. And stuff
right,
like that,
so. Just the red line itself.
Or red color, whatever color you have for a line. Or,
yeah, right, it could be any color, depending on your bow.
You just rub it in. So that way the line is nice and good, nice and strong, no frays.
It keeps it from falling apart and coming apart on itself. Get all hairy and stringy, which they call it frayed, for any new people looking at the video. If you're just completely unaware of everything and you want to learn. Highly recommend you go to a professional course, take a professional safety course. Whether it is recommended in your state or required for hunting, safety courses are extremely important. And you should definitely take a safety course when it comes to firing any type of a weapon at all, firearms and bows. I took safety courses. I'm also an Army sniper, and he's also an Army veteran. But he took a course for the bow, and you know, safety is so important. And I don't care who you are, you're probably gonna learn something. So there's different techniques. To any military veterans out there, you're looking at two military veterans right now that go hunting actively, but safety is very important. And there's a difference between being in combat and being out in the field hunting with other hunters and everything. So please, do yourself a favor, just take a safety course. It's a very smart thing to do.
Anyhow, so I had a
that's not gonna even learn that for me. site.
And I went on there to
there's no way
post my account.
I can get this line up with that.
Yeah.
Unless so I go like this. Like when I'm like this, that site's over here. So I can't line up the site right.
And I almost was gonna.
Well, that fails because I'll never get a true sight. And you can't turn this because that will throw your shot off. So you would think like a rifle, it doesn't matter. With a bow, it totally matters. So I'm not going to take a shot with this. I don't know where it's going to go because I can't line up the sight. And I don't want to lose an arrow. All right. So how would I measure a bow for me? Like, I'm trying yours on, and we're seeing that this is too short. The bow is too small. So how would I measure?
Well, this bow will be good for you, too. But
you have to adjust
both these.
Both of these.
The very, very max is 30 inches. So 58. Straight back for you.
Straight back for me.
But this bow is the same. It's just gotta get it.
You have to adjust it. And that's just because of my long arms.
The long arms and the long fingers.
And my fingers, and my long fingers.
Yep.
So where should that be on my hand?
Right there.
Right down here.
Yeah, where you,
this so what are we, like muscle. 2 inches short almost?
Yep.
Wow. And that makes the world of difference. So when I pulled back to take a shot, this sight right here, and I don't know if the camera can see it, but that's an eyesight. And you want to look through here and see that dot. When I pull back, that sight right there is way off here in right field. And the only way to get it there, I would have to turn, but you can't do that in a bow. You have to keep the bow level. There's a level right in here. That must be level with this. There's a lot that goes into this that you don't think about when you're first getting into bow hunting. That's why you got to go take a class and go check it out and get into it.
And go to a person that will teach you how to properly shoot a bow. Because they'll sight in for you. They will adjust it to where it's your eye level. This is my eye level. This is not his eye level. This is my eye level. This is my height, my length. Everything is set to me. So someone like him comes in.
I can't just use your bow if we went out in the field one hunting and be like, hey, let me use your bow and take a shot. You're two different people, two different makes. So you got a different frame. My arm's longer than his. It's a different measurement. And so the bow has to be adjusted to the measurement of the archer. And so that's why your equipment is very important. This is easy to size up in the store. This, you just do your adjustment according to your arms. So, cool. Well, let's
that's why I wanted to show them, because
I'm gonna have to buy one now.
People always say, oh, go to the pawn shop and go get a bow. They can't adjust.
You can't.
So go to a professional.
You want to go to a sporting goods store. So I know that Cabela's Outdoor World, they'll do it. They'll do it for you.
They'll do it for free.
Yep.
It's all free. All you have to do is just buy a bow.
This isn't a sponsorship. They're not partnered. We're not affiliated. We're just naming stores that are in our neighborhood that we can go to.
This is how it's supposed to be in your hand.
Right, like that.
So you can get that.
And I could not even do that. I had to manipulate my hand forward and then come try to reach back to the trigger.
And everything wasn't comfortable for him. It was very uncomfortable for him. For me, it's comfortable because it sets my height.
Number one rule, if you're uncomfortable and it doesn't fit, don't take a shot. Don't use the equipment, you know, because you could lose stuff, hurt somebody, break something, do something. no good.
It's no good. This is brand new, it's still good.
Yeah, any cracking at all, never shoot that arrow, throw it away.
Throw it away, yep.
Break it and throw it away.
Yep.
Don't just throw it away. Somebody else that doesn't know might pick it up and try to use it. Break it and throw it away. All right, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. We're going to wrap it up here. Thanks for watching. Subscribe, like, share, and we'll see you next time right here on Bigfoot Army. Thanks a lot, guys. Bye.